Lord. And JRMSU is so lucky to have you as if you're bringing Australia University into our campus. My name is Verla Villasco from the policy campus. And presently, I'm busy with coordinating our pre-service teachers for the internship in the field. I'm a believer always of the miracle of the best practices and the benefits we could have in benchmarking. In the Department of Education, that's basic education in the Philippines, the master teachers and the teacher pre position teachers presently are required to come up with an action plan, action research. So the part of their promotion, and most of them have high regards of the probably experiences from faculties and the higher education. Anyway, so finally, I would really love to hear any best practices so that the university could benchmark as well. Not necessarily from Australia University. What have you done with in terms of collaboration to help these basic education teachers come up with a very acceptable, probably or a fruitful action research? Yeah, that's it.
Sorry, I was writing a few words that I think are very important.
This is the question, otherwise I forget.
Back in my
perspective, one thing I always do naturally if you try to, whenever somebody uses a word, I question what that word is and question the limitation of that word. Every level in psychosocialism, all those things, I always question what does it mean, what are the assumptions behind it, and what are the limitations.
So you asked, you mentioned
best practice, benchmarking, and action plan. And me as a theoretical expert or theoretician, I ask, what do you mean? What do you mean? What is best practice? Is there a practice that is best than all other practices? And we keep doing research till we find it, and once we find it, that's showing up. That's paradox. I don't believe so. Because what is the best practice in my mind is what is the best practice for that teacher with that group of students during the pandemic, for example. We don't have the pandemic. It's another practice that is best. And with this teacher, another practice may be best. So I don't find that discourse of best practice. I know what people mean by it, but I don't adhere to that image. So maybe I change that word in my conversation to good practice, productive practice, or productive practices. So I'm more interested in how do we understand good practice individually, what is good for you and what is good for somebody else might be different. Okay? So benchmarking, I don't like as well. This is kind of comparing apples and oranges in our clients. Okay? So you publish 3 articles in a year, or I publish 10. I'm not necessarily better than you. Maybe I'm full-time publishing and you're doing it on the side. Maybe you are better than me. So the benchmarking that says compare the 10 with the 3. Well, how I change it, I would say, have conversations with them. Look at their practices, and you say, that's interesting. I'll try it. Well, when I say God, I mean the word on my grasp, because it means one computer, but if you see it, forget about it. Okay? So the language that we use gives us a particular way of thinking behind it. And then it becomes so really beautiful. It becomes almost meaningless. So my theory, my theoretical political perspective says there is no good practice. We learn from each other, let's go to each other. This is each other, let's go to I do this, I do that, I find this useful. This is not possible to do, let's go to each other. Benchmarking as a formal process of tips and processes and all that kind of thing, I think it's useful. Search for the best practice is useless. The topic is useful, actually. That is another consideration. I was going to start the lecture today, if I gave the lecture, by talking about the age of absurdity. Age of absurdity. In the 70s, they started using that term, the uncertainty, by economists. People were trying to predict the economy and the stock market. They realized that all those theories, all that research that they developed, is not able to predict the market, the stock market very well. And then we use it in other areas of education, other areas of work. Think about the pandemic. 2 or 3 years ago, whatever, faced the pandemic, dying, we stay at home, and we hope the science will find an answer. That's what it's did. And one year, they found a vaccine to a type of virus that they've been researching for 10 or 20 years without any vaccine. The common cold is similar to coronavirus. It is a coronavirus, and we don't have vaccines. So in 1 year, they found the vaccine. Well, science is successful. Who would have predicted the reaction of the people against the virus?
Nobody.
It doesn't work, and it's not valid, and it's not, proven, and they put in chips in my blood. Who would have predicted that? Think about internet. Facebook was wonderful. People can talk to each other across the countries and collaborate with each other. Who would have predicted the misinformation?
Disinformation.
Crime. That is committed through nobody can do it. Lot of times with the best intention, best knowledge, best theory, best practices, but the outcome is completely unpredictable. I don't think that action planning, I don't want to dismiss it, but the model after it is specify exactly what you want to do and how you're going to achieve it, and evaluate whether you achieve it or not. You do that in teaching and policy and everything you need to do. And the assumption is that if you follow that recipe, you will continue to improve. So we don't listen. It doesn't leave any room for the unexpected. It doesn't go in the way people feel and react. And so on. Life is messier than that. I'm not saying action planning, throw it away, or lesson plans, throw them away, it doesn't, life doesn't work. I'm not saying that. It's important to plan what you want to do, to know exactly what you're trying to achieve. But don't put yourself in a straitjacket to avoid. Life is much, much more complex than those seniors else.
I know you have some education problems.
Yes. Because sometimes we can't expect it. It's a blessing. It's not our plan, it's something we have to care for. We have flexibility to change our plans and learn from the situation. So, how can we act? How can we behave? In a world that is uncertain. Yes. We're going to question this development. No, we can't do that. We can't plan at all. But we cannot, we have to plan everything. We have to be able to justify why we're doing what we're doing.
We could be wrong.
None will tell. At least at this moment, that is my best decision. I'm doing it clearly in terms of why I'm more effective. When you see a things that I've developed, respond to it ethically as well. So ethically, saying that, you know, maybe I was able to increase the achievement of students, but maybe I lost the self of agency. And maybe learning to be me. I think that's a very basic question.